one.
Sorry, you'll be English then, but I will try to speak convicted. if you don't understand anything, I will try to speak slower. If I'm too fast, you just tell me. Very fast. Okay. So ako si Dolly, taga Singapore. I'm one of the missionaries living in Pasig, if you haven't met me. And I'm very happy to see that your happy faces this morning. And hear your happy voices that you're playing the bagyo, what?
Bahay.
Bahay. Tao. Ah, okay. Yes. And yeah, I don't know if you're rest well yesterday. I heard some slippery soundly. Yeah, and yeah, no, I think it was a long day, your recovery journey and all. So I hope you did rest. And if not, I hope the heat earlier on woke you up a bit. No, the question that was continuously repeated. Who are you? Sino ka? So that big question that was again and again repeated in the skit. And isn't it that when someone asks us this question today, you know, it's normal we will if somebody asks you, who are you? You know, it's normal we will answer with our name, or what we are doing, or where we come from. But this morning, you know, let us discover answers to this big question, who are you? This big question, that maybe we might have different names, different answers to this question, different backgrounds, we have different capacities. And yeah, and the list goes on. But all of us, we are united by one truth. One truth. We are children of God, our Father. So in 1 John 3, verse 1, it says, see what love the Father has bestowed on us, that we may be called the children of God. Yet so we are. Yet so we are. We know and can be sure we are God's children. Alam natin at natitiyak natin na tayo ay mga anak ng Diyos. In Wisdom 2, verse 23, he says, he formed us to be imperishable. Of his, the image of his own nature, he made us. So, we know we are God's children because of our nature. The image of his own nature in which he made us. Now think about it. How do we know our parents are our parents or our lolo, lolas, our titas? Our lolos and lolas. Maybe because we have same features, similar features. The same small nose, I don't know. Same eyes. Maybe we have the similar characteristics. Maybe we react to things in similar ways. Likewise, we share features and characteristics with God. What are some of them? Una, God is perfect. Ang Diyos ay perfecto. Tayo rin nakahanap ng pagiging perfecto. We are not contented to be where we are. We seek to be the best in what we do, be it singing, studies, etc. For example, dancing, you know. I think it isn't enough to dance well. Maybe some of you want to be like BTS, or be like Blackpink. It's not just dancing well, no. We always seek to be the best. We find ourselves asking for more. No? Pangalawa, God is all-knowing and powerful. Ang Diyos ay nakakaalam ng lahat. Makakapangyarihan. Tayo rin naghanap ng malaman. Manuuna waan ang mga bagay, sorry. We ask deep questions about life, like, sino ako? Ano ang buhay? No? Thirdly, God is a creator with big dreams. We too, we seek newness and deep down, we have a dream for our lives, diba? No, maybe we have dreams to go abroad to study, to work. We want to graduate. you want to graduate from school, you want to find a good job. And pang-apat, God is eternity. Ang Diyos ay walang hanggan. This is the greatest gift He has given to us daily. Because we too, we seek eternity. We want to live. We want to live. No, and what are those signs that we want to live? I think there are many signs, but first, we take care of our appearances to ensure that we look good. And not only that, this is a sign that we want to live, but also, we want to be remembered. Now, I think one thing that really amazed me here in the Philippines is that when you graduate or when you change school, you share your passport photos with one another. Diba? I don't know if now you all still do that. Yes. I don't know if the young generation you all still do that. But some of your aunties and tuyas. No? But the idea is because we don't just share our photo for no reason. We want our friends to remember us. And not only do we want to be remembered, takot din tayong makalimutan nila. Isn't it so that it matters to us that our friends, especially our close friends, remembers our birthdays? And we feel bad when they forget us. For example, when we are left out from an invitation to a party. Because deep down lies our desire to be remembered forever. We don't want to be forgotten. Diba? Bakit? Because we fear to be nothing for the other. Dahil natatakot tayong maging wala para sa iba. It's as if we are non-existent, invisible. No, because all of us, tayo rin, gusto natin magbuhay at gusto natin maging mahalaga para sa iba. For God formed us to be imperishable in Wisdom 2 verse 23. No, He made us in His own nature in many aspects. He made each one of us in a very unique and special way. But really, the greatest gift of all is His own nature of His. He formed us to be imperishable. He gives us His own life, the gift of eternal life. And when we love someone, we won't want that they die, isn't it? No? Isn't it so that one of our greatest fears is the passing of our loved ones? Our mother, our father, our sibling, and we will do all we can to keep them alive. I remember personally, when I was younger, my cousin was very sick with cancer. And at the age of 16 he had cancer. And so his parents tried all means, brought him to the hospital again and again for treatment. They want to keep him alive, of course. And likewise, God the Father is the same. And when He tells us, when He says to you, mahal kita, He meant, hindi ka mamatay. But, we still die, isn't it? We still die. No, like my cousin whom I just shared, he was sick, and eventually at the age of 18, he passed away. And what then does God really mean? What does God mean that when He say that we are eternal? In reality, what is eternal is our nature. When God gives us His nature of eternity, it is our essence, our identity. Our identity is the pag-ibig ang ating pagkakakilanlan. What is identity? No, identity is something unchanging. Sometimes maybe we might confuse them with titles, with status, with achievements, what we do, what we own. But all these things change, no? they will disappear one day. And one day, we will also not be a student. We will be working like your Puyas and Ateas here. And one day, we will not even remember the awards we won in school. One day, the things we own will be outdated. And even sport. But our identity is unchanging. Our identity is unchanging. Now, identity is something that no one and no situation can take away from us. Ang makapagkakakilanlan ay isang bagay na walang sinuman at walang sitwasyon ng maaaring maawala sa atin. Our titles of being the best in dancing, in a competition, and even in our studies, no one day somebody will be better than us. This is the truth. Even our names can be changed and taken away from us. But the depth of our identity is something that no one, no situation can take away. No, I remember someone who discovered her name was changed when she was very young. And when she first knew it, you know, her name was changed, she was questioning a lot. Sino ako? Sino ako? Because her parents never told her about it and never seemed like they want to speak about it. She felt very unsettled. But in prayer one day, she understood God telling her, "You are my child. Your deepest identity is love." So this helped her so much that she understood that the core of her identity, whatever might have happened, whatever life situations might bring or tear us apart, this identity, your life is love. Ang buhay mo ay pag-ibig. This is something that no one, no situation, nothing can take away from us. No one, not even our parents, not even our siblings, not even our relatives. Even if our names are taken out, even if our talents are taken out from us, our capacities are taken out, your identity is love. And that can never be taken out from us. It can never be taken out from us. Your life is love. This is the very essence of our life. Our identity is love, and this identity, this nature, this is eternal. No, kaya kung tayo ay walang hanggan, bakit tayo namatay? What exactly is eternal life? Ano ba talaga ang buhay na walang hanggan? Firstly, eternal life is not a place after we die. No? It's not a place where we go. No? I don't know what you imagine eternal life as, a place that we go. Well, I was young, I had that. Or a space where we go where we will see the angels, where the angels are singing. No? It's not a place after we die. And secondly, ang buhay na walang hanggan ay isang tao, isang relasyon. It's a relationship. Now in John 17:3, it says, "This is eternal life, that they should know you, the only true God, the one whom you sent, Jesus Christ." Now, eternal life means to know you, the only true God. And this speaks so much of a relationship. For Jesus had a close and intimate relationship with God. And eternal life is thus living with God. To know Him not just in the books, in the papers, but really as a friend. Personally. To be able to share with Him face to face. To be able to talk to Him as His child. And thirdly, eternal life. What is eternal life? Eternal life is love. Ang buhay na walang hanggan ay pag-ibig. It is what gives us the drive, the desire to go for more. In 2 Corinthians 5:14, he says, the love of Christ impels us. It pushes us forth. It gives us that energy. Ang pag-ibig na ito nasa loob, sa loob natin ay nagtutulad sa atin. Because we are not easily satisfied. He drives us to see possibilities in difficulties, to hope and to search. It gives us the capacity to bear sufferings, to be able to have perspective of the resurrection. No, and fourthly, ang buhay na walang hanggan ay hindi isang oras pagkatapos mamatay tayo. It's not a time after we die. Because eternity in itself speaks of forever, of a constant. It doesn't begin only when we die, but it begins when we live. It begins when we live. And this is the moment. When is this moment? Well, yesterday, Elaine was sharing. This is the moment when we are conceived, no? When we are born that champion, when we are conceived in our mother's womb. And maybe today, the image of the baby in the womb of the mother will help us to understand eternal life. When the baby is conceived, he or she, you know, imagine yourself growing in your mother's womb. And during that time, the baby and the mother, they cannot see each other. But they feel the presence of each other. The baby knows there's someone nourishing him, her, there's someone protecting. The baby listens to the sound of the mother. And on the other hand, the mother, who is pregnant, feels the movement of the baby within her. She feels how her child is growing in her. And yeah, even though she cannot see the face of the child. And likewise, eternal life is similar, no? It's like that. Like a baby, we don't yet see the face of God now. But we know someone is nourishing, someone is protecting us, someone is taking care of us. And when we die, we come face to face with God. Just as the baby sees the face of the mother, then he or she is born. No? In the passage from 2 Corinthians 4, verse 16 to 18, it says, our inner self is being renewed day by day. Our inner self is what that never dies, is what that is eternal. And our inner self is love. This is the unseen which is eternal. Just as the baby needs time and has time developing inside the mother's womb. So this time now is a time we are growing, we are being configured to be who we are meant to be. If a baby doesn't develop well in the mother's womb, what will happen? He will become lifeless or incomplete when he or she is born. And likewise, if we don't live well our life now, we will also possibly be born lifeless when we seek our face to face. Thus, no, it's not too late. We can live well our life, live well eternal life, here and now. We need to focus firstly, how to do so. We need to focus on the essentials. No? And this is why Jesus said, our identity is imperishable. He wants us to focus on the essential, which is eternal. And that is our identity. The identity of love. Sometimes we focus on what doesn't last, and it can shake our true identity. You know? Maybe sometimes we think that, yeah, I am my grade. I am what I can achieve. I am my valedictorian title. I am my looks. I am my capacity. And if we don't achieve, then we think we are nothing. we are not our grades. We are not just our capacities. We are not just our moods. They might be a part of us. True, they are a part of us. But they are not our true, full identity. Because our full, our deepest identity is love. You are love. And so we need to focus on this essential of life, the eternal in life. Then in Luke 9, verse 25, he threw us this question saying, what profit is there for one to gain the whole world, yet lose or forfeit himself? So what profit is there for us? To be the best in Mobile Legends, Call of Duty, or all other games, yet lose the time to share face-to-face with our friends? What profit is there to spend all our time keeping connected and up-to-date with our friends online, with the trends on TikTok and Facebook, but we lose the connection with our loved ones that are right beside us? What profit is there to gain instant satisfaction from watching things that are not appropriate online, and lose the true satisfaction that comes from loving those around us authentically? What profit is there to gain everything, yet lose our very self, our identity? Our identity that is love. No, we need to live each day focusing on the essentials of life, and that is what is eternal. No, a few years ago when I was still working, I had a colleague, a friend, who had a very rare heart condition. I cannot remember the name. But basically, she doesn't know if she will collapse suddenly and not wake up. And then she shared with me, of course I was shocked, and she shared with me how at the beginning when she first knew this condition of hers, she just started working actually, she was young then. And she lived with a lot of fear because it made her live life with a lot of limitations. She lived a lot of fear because she didn't know if the next moment she will collapse, she will die. The doctor told her it might happen very suddenly. And so, she was very afraid to pursue many things in life. And it made her feel very empty, you know. Like, no life. Why I feel like no life, she shared. And she asked herself then. But one day, this question suddenly came to her. What if today is my last day? How would I live? What if today is my last day? How would I live? And it really marked her and changed how she lived her condition. Because she understood that maybe she doesn't know tomorrow, she doesn't know next week what will happen to her. But she has today. She has today. And that made her really strive to live each day fully. Because she knew she still had today, and she strived to live each day fully, learning to focus more on the essentials of life. She shared how, through the years, she discovered really, along the way, what is essential. And it is nothing other than love. And this is the essence of her daily self-giving, right to this very day. She's still alive, and now she's married with two kids, and doing many things. Though she still is on daily medication, the condition remains the same. But she lives continuously, daily, with her daily self-giving, loving her family, her colleagues. She's very involved with the migrants, the refugees. She continues to express her identity of love. Not today, she lives with more and more conviction that her identity, that is love, is really what she needs to focus on each day. It's the essential of life. Ang pag-ibig ang makakasama. halal. It is eternal. And it's what we need to focus on in each moment of our life. Ang pag-ibig ang ating pagkakakilanlan at ang pag-ibig ay walang hanggan. Love is our identity and love is eternal. Ang pag-ibig ay walang limitasyon. There's no limitations. It goes beyond time. It reaches out beyond geographical boundaries. And love trespasses death. No. In this time of Holy Week, I think we will witness it, you know, in many ways. And really, we will witness it through Jesus on the cross and His resurrection. No, and love is transcendent. We have the capacity to be the best of us, and not only that, to go beyond us. Also, love is the same in the time of Jesus and today. It matters to the people then, 2023 years ago. And today, it continues to matter to us now, isn't it? When you think about all the songs that we are listening, most all of it speaks of love. And also love transforms nation. Ang pag-ibig ay nagbabago sa mga bansa. Look at how the young girl, I don't know if you remember the young girl called Anna Patricia. She's the one who started the community pantry, you know, which I'm sure all of you know about the community pantry. And it's just a simple act of love, but it transformed our nation. It created a ripple effect of love all around. Everyone started sharing, giving what they had. And love is also that common language among us. Even if we don't understand each other's language, we perceive the love of each other. Diba? No, personally, this has been my experience. No? I don't really speak that a lot. And sometimes I don't understand the other. No, I think you have experience with me. Now. It's you, Lisa, when you are very shy. You don't speak and I don't understand. And I will ask your colleague. And, no, but I perceive the love behind. No, and I think love is this common language that even if you go to any country, yeah, you don't understand them, but you can perceive love them. And love makes a mark in the world. You look at how Mother Teresa, how she loved and inspired many to join her mission all around the world. And even though she passed away 26 years ago, maybe many of you are not born yet, but you still know her. And many still know what she do, what is her work. You still know. Because her love that she expressed, God's love that she expressed through her life, makes a mark in the world. And these different aspects of love reveals to us one thing, the eternity of love. Ang pag-ibig ay walang hanggan ay iyong ang ating pagkakakilanlan. When we don't live our identity, we are restless. Maybe we find ourselves trying to fit in different places. But when we live our identity, we will experience feeling more coherent in our life. We will experience being able to live with more passion. Remember the skit at the beginning? When was it that Maria experienced that existence, that call of her existence? When she discovered that core of her identity, when did she found the meaning and passion? It was when she found the core of her identity, her essence, her existence. And that is love. And imagine how would it be if each one of us believed our life out fully, we live out fully our identity of love. How much miracles can we create in the world? How much can we transform the world in our life? In Luke 12, verse 49, Jesus says, I have come to set the earth on fire, and how I wish it were really blazing. When Jesus lived his identity of love fully, He lived his life with so much passion of love, and he inspired the lives of many. And in his time, he touched many and inspired. In his time, he touched many and healed and inspired many. But today, even 2023 years after his death, it continues. His life continues to contrast the lives of many today. Our identity as love, when we live fully, it can set the earth on fire. Maybe it will come out like a volcano eruption. No, that love that will come out like a volcano eruption. Ikaw din mo, bawat isa sa inyo, ay may kakayahan mabuhay ng lubusan ang iyong pagkakakilala ng pag-ibig. You too have the capacity to live out fully your identity of love. You have the capacity to set this earth on fire with your love. You can live out your identity of love in the here and now. And you can begin by receiving and developing this identity. So how? How can you begin developing this identity? How can you begin living in the here and now? Ang una, you can listen to him, share with him through the word of God. So these days of encounter is a very opportune time for us to begin learning wisdom. Sometimes in life, maybe we receive many labels that we unconsciously start to believe that it's our identity. Unknown labels. Labels like you are stupid, you are slow, you are hopeless, you are nobody, you are disappointment. No, all these voices, sometimes they are external. But when we believe in them, it starts to be our internal voice within us. Like every mistake we do starts to affirm that false identities of us. See, you failed again, you are hopeless now. But today, God wants to change them. When we listen and share with him, he wants to tell us this. You are my beloved child, with whom I am loved. You are love, with whom I am well pleased. You are love. Today God wants to help us to receive again this identity of ours. This identity that is today and forever. This identity that is love. And he invites us to listen to him through his word daily and to share with him. Allowing not the voices around us, not the voices within us to speak louder than the voices of than his voice. He wants us to allow his voice to speak louder to us than all the other voices we might hear. Ikaw ay anak ko. Ang iyong pagkakakilanlan ay pag-ibig. Ngayon at magpakailanlan. You can also receive and develop your identity of love by sharing and living out the word of God. Because when we share and live the word of God, we root more deeply in our own identity. In a measure, we listen and believe in that unchanging identity that is love. In a measure, we share it. It's the same measure that we allow this identity of love to take deeper root in us, in our lives. I like this quote very much. It's very long. You will receive the quote later. There's this part of this quote by this author, Marian Wilson, that says, we ask ourselves, who am I to be brilliant, gorgeous, talented, fabulous? Actually, who are you not to be? You are a child of God. We are all meant to shine. As children do. We were born to manifest the glory of God that is within us, that is already there, it's deep within us. And it's not just in some of us, but in each one of you, each one of us. And as we let our own light shine, it gives others the permission also to shine, to do the same. When we let our own light, this light that is the identity of love shine, consciously give others the permission to do the same. And this helps us also to receive and develop this love that is already deep within us. So in other words, we have the capacity to live our identity of love fully. And this not only frees us to live our lives fully with passion, but it also frees others too. It also allows others, influence others to dream big, to lead their life with passion, to live out their identity as love. Now, of course, that said, receiving and developing this identity of love is not easy. It entails a lot of dying to our false beliefs and values of ours that might have been part of our life for a long time. It's a daily exercise to listen to share the word, to go beyond the word. And personally, believing and living this identity as love isn't always easy for me because I grew up in an environment that speaks so much of identity as my career, my achievements, my responsibilities. And I grew up with the belief to know that really, I need to live up to my identity. And if I don't, I am nothing. Of course, I was tired and upset each time I failed. It was really difficult to live life with passion in that way. I remember one time, I failed an exam in college. And I felt really very sad. I started to carry many negative voices in me. Like, I'm stupid, I'm nothing. And I felt very lifeless. And that time, I was helping out with catechism in my parish. And I really didn't want to go, but my friend, you know, messaged me and said he really needed help that weekend, so okay, I went. And to my surprise, just randomly, a child suddenly that day decided to give me a bookmark. And on the bookmark at the back, it was the serenity prayer. It says, God, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, the courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. And at the bookmark, the back, the little boy wrote a short note to me. He says, thank you. And yeah, I felt like to the little child, to the little 8-year-old child, God was reminding me that I am. It wasn't about what I can do, but simply who I am. And that is love. So encountering God really changed my life. And it's still a long process that we will always be on. A journey, believing, holding on to His word daily, that you are my beloved child. It's a daily exercise, really learning, allowing His words to reaffirm us again and again of our true identity. And what about you? Do you believe that you matter? Your identity is love simply because of who you are. Ikau at ibi. You are not what you can do, nor are you your dream. Living our identity of love is how we can discover our passion in living life. You are love, and so you need to invest your life in love in the here and now. How we can be a giver of love? Because when we live and invest our life in giving eternal life, this is the consequence. In Deuteronomy 30:19, it says, you choose life not only for yourself, but you choose life for many around you. We can live eternal life in the here and now, living our identity of love. And this can be little ways, little actions, listening to the voice of God inviting us to love. For example, helping our parents, or maybe one day we choose to play a little less game to help with the chores at home. To study not alone, but to study with our friends, to help our friends in their studies, to share what we have with those in need, and so on. Now, these little actions can make a big difference in the world. As St. Teresa of Calcutta shared, I alone cannot change the world, but I can cast a stone across the waters to create many ripples. So let us cast this stone across the water through living our identity of love. We can create many ripples in the world. Do you want to set the world on fire? Do you want power of change to make the difference, to transform the lives of many. Do you want to leave your mark in the world? You can do it in the here and now, simply by living your identity of love. Invest your love, your life in love today, because it is what is eternal, and giving our identity is what gives us life within. This life burning with passion. And you can live your life fully with passion in the here and now today, because you are love. Para sa iyong pag-ibig. So now we will have a moment of silence. Again, to pray to share with him. In a moment, we will also distribute a handout of prayer that might help also in